This episode is brought to you by Dashlane. Try Dashlane Premium free for 30 days at dashlane.com/infographics and never forget another password and keep all your online accounts secure. Chances are, you've all used a personal computer that runs the Windows operating system, but how many of you have actually used Linux? If you look at the market share of operating systems for PCs over the last few years, you'll see that Windows totally dominates the market. It's been that way pretty much since Windows came on the scene in 1985. The word Microsoft became a household name and synonymous with both home computers and operating systems. In January 2019, Windows had just over an 88% market share. Apple's Mac operating system is next with just over 9% of the share. And after that comes Linux with just a tiny share. What might surprise you though is perhaps this shouldn't really be the case. We're not going to bother explaining to you what the Windows OS is. That would be almost condescending. You've all used it, and many of you probably loved the XP version, hated Vista and Windows ME, and probably weren't too fond of Windows 8. When Microsoft released Windows 10, it said this was the last in the line of totally new versions. It would be updated forevermore. The point is, we've likely all gotten used to Windows. Using Windows is as familiar to most people as opening a window in your home. It's that familiarity, and of course the fact that it comes pre-installed on many PCs you buy, that prevents some people from crossing over the scary waters of OS change toward the little-known island of Linux. For those of you who don't know what Linux is, you can actually just go to the Linux official website and the company answers that question for you. We've done the reading, so we'll paraphrase what the company said. First of all, Linux tells us you probably do use Linux but just don't know about it. This is just one sentence from its grand opening paragraph. It's in your phones, in your cars, in your refrigerators, your Roku devices. It runs most of the internet, the supercomputers making scientific breakthroughs, and the world's stock exchanges. It's also just a regular operating system for your PC. The operating system, which most people just initialize to OS, is like the brain of the machine. Without it, the machine is pretty much useless. We don't need to tell you that these systems can be very complex, and we imagine most of you wouldn't be confident enough to say you know exactly everything you can do with your Windows OS. That's one reason people stick with what they know, because moving to a different OS is like finding yourself in a totally new environment. You have to learn the laws of a new virtual jungle, which can be exciting, but also a bit frustrating at times. But get this, you can install Linux on your computer for nothing. Yes, it is absolutely free. Installing a Linux server is also free. This is what you need when you have a network of people that need serving. It isn't free if you need Windows Server OS though. Linux makes a big deal about this, and rightly so. Who doesn't like free? Linux also says its server is easy to run and that anyone can do it. Okay, so the next big point when discussing Linux is the fact that it's distributed under an open source license. What does this mean? Well, basically, you can do whatever you want with your OS, which is great for many folks since they enjoy the fact that they can study exactly how it works and make a change. Imagine you were not into a Windows feature and then thought, okay, I can do this better. I'll just rewrite the code and add something. Linux lets you do this. Linux also notes these two things, that users have the freedom to redistribute copies so you can help your neighbor. People also have the freedom to distribute copies of your modified versions to others. This is why Linux users like to say they're part of a community. A common phrase is it's an OS that's run by the people for the people. The same way you can tinker under the hood of a car, Linux lets you see what's inside. Some folks like to get under the hood, that's just their nature. Linux really works for these people. So, this is starting to sound too good to be true. An easy to use, free OS that doesn't break much, and one that you can alter and fiddle with and improve. Anything else? Yes, in fact, there is. Linux has a lot of versions to choose from, but the company calls them distributions, so you have quite a few choices of how you want your OS to work and what your desktop will look like. When we say a few, we actually mean hundreds, if not thousands. Some are more popular than others, and if you choose, you can opt for a version that's pretty close to Windows in look and feel. If you like the Apple Mac OS, there's a Linux distribution that tries to mirror that. Another major point is that Linux is less vulnerable to attacks than Windows. Who's had a virus before? What about some particularly hard-to-remove malware? Who's been hit so hard they felt like taking a hammer to their blue screen of death? Now, you might be thinking, wait a minute here, if Linux is basically an open-source system, surely it must be vulnerable to attacks. Well, we are told by the security experts that Linux is actually harder to gain access to, so fewer files can be corrupted. It's a long story, but the way Linux is designed makes it less likely to suffer from viruses. It can happen, but it happens a lot less than on the average computer using Windows. Of course, there's also the fact that Windows is way more popular, so of course, that's the system people want to hack. We're also told that running a Linux OS requires less power, so in other words, you could run the system on an older computer. So it's reliable, easy to run, allows you to choose from many distributions, allows developers to fiddle around, and it's free. So come on, there must be a downside because hardly anyone in the world uses it compared to Windows. Something just doesn't add up here. Well, Windows being so huge means it has much more software you can run on it. There are thousands of programs you can run on Linux for free, and you can even get Windows software on Linux. With a bit of effort, you can even have your beloved Microsoft Word running on your Linux machine. But in all, Windows offers a much wider variety of software. What about the hardware supporting the software? Well, it's said in the past you might have had trouble getting Linux on a machine, but that's a thing of the past. Most machines you can buy today should be able to run Linux without issue. Enough of the expert commentary, though. Let's see what real people who have switched from Windows to Linux have to say. The most popular comment on one Reddit thread was, "At the end of the day, the Linux community wants to make software, and Microsoft wants to make money. When those goals are opposed, Linux becomes the better choice." In fact, a lot of the people who now use Linux say that they're very happy they made the change, and mostly for the reasons we have talked about today. Another person wrote, "Updates not bugging you, it's faster, no spyware, runs well on older machines, tons of variety, and penguins." He likes penguins. Another person wrote, "It's free, as in freedom. No stupid licenses that tell you you can't use your computer the way you want to. You're free to use it for any purpose, change it, redistribute it, and to distribute the changes you make. It's software that's useful for society." We didn't see many negative comments for Linux, but one person said when it comes to gaming, Windows is better, as the games are designed to run on Windows. He also said that as Windows 10 is the entire deal, Microsoft is focused on making it the perfect environment. It's coherent, he said, whereas the Linux world is massive, and for some people, that could be confusing. Actually, when it comes to Linux and gaming, you can find many forums with people arguing about this. This is what one very popular gaming website said. "Yes, Linux is a decent operating system for gaming, especially since the number of Linux-compatible games is increasing due to Valve's SteamOS being based on Linux. However, we would still advise anyone who doesn't need any of the advanced features that Linux has to offer to stick with Windows due to its ease of use and fewer compatibility issues with games." So, with all this positivity being spoken about Linux, why is its market share not even 2%? You can read tech websites where real computer nerds talk about this. And you'll see people saying that Linux really should be ascending faster than it is. But actually, one developer said what we've just said, in that Linux is just far too fragmented. He also just said the obvious, in that it just hasn't gained momentum yet. And well, Microsoft has a PR machine that's virtually unstoppable. This is not to say, however, that Windows is bad. Not at all, and Windows 10 has been, for the most part, very well received. As we said at the beginning, Windows has been part of people's lives for many years. People know what they're working with, and even though Linux offers similar alternatives, a lot of people don't want to make the effort to change. There's also the case for a long time people haven't gone over to Linux because they thought it was only for people who knew a lot about computers. That using it might take some amount of computer savvy. There is no doubt that people will have to do some learning, and as we already said, you're entering a different jungle. But no, you don't have to be a computer science major to use a Linux computer. That said, some people just don't want to have to learn something new. And on top of that, if a computer comes with a pre-installed version of Windows and works well enough, why on earth would they go through the effort to change? No matter which you choose, Windows, Linux, or even a different OS altogether, one threat is constant. Hackers. And it's not just big companies that are at risk, but everyday people like you and me. And in fact, you might be a bigger target than a company with professional security. That's why you need Dashlane. Think of them as your own personal cyber bodyguard in a dangerous cyber world, and the one and only tool you need to keep safe online. We now make sure our whole team is secured by Dashlane, with a VPN, password generator, and breach alerts to let you know when your logins suffer breaches or hacks. Dashlane actively works to protect you across all your devices and online accounts so you can rest easy. Head on over to www.dashlane.com/infographics for a free 30-day trial, and if you use the coupon code infographics, you can get 10% off a premium subscription today.